مجمع الأندلس التعليمي، تعلم عصري ملهم بهوية وطنية وقيم إسلامية.
Good morning students and welcome to our new grammar lesson for today. Today we are going to deal with conditional sentences, types, zero and first. By the end of this video, we are expected to recognize the structure and use of the zero and first conditionals. Of course, this includes using alternative words which we can use instead of if. Secondly, we are asked to practice dealing with different types of questions related to the target grammar rule. To begin our lesson, please let me invite you to watch the following video, which demonstrates the use of zero and first conditionals. Then we can continue our tasks.
6 minute grammar from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to 6 minute grammar with me, Neil.
And me, Catherine. Hello.
Now, Catherine, would you like to have some of this delicious chocolate
oh,
I've got here?
Oh, Neil, I'd love to, but I can't. When I eat chocolate, I get terrible headaches.
Oh, that's bad luck.
I know, it's horrible.
If I eat chocolate, I just get fat.
Do you? You don't look it. You look thin.
It's all the cycling, you see. I can eat whatever I want because of all the cycling.
Lucky you.
Now, in this program, we're looking at the zero conditional and the first conditional.
We'll be discussing why and when we use them.
We'll see how to form them.
We'll help you decide which ones to use in which situation.
And we'll bring you a quiz at the end of the show.
So listen carefully and take some notes.
Let's start by looking at the zero conditional. We use it to talk about things which always happen in particular situations.
For example, I always get a headache if I eat chocolate. And we also use the zero conditional to talk about facts and truths. And here's Finn with our first example.
If you drop an apple, it falls to the ground.
That's gravity for you. Now, there are two parts to the sentence. The part with if, plus the present simple, tells us the situation. And the other part is in the present simple tense and tells us what happens as a result of the if situation. Here's Finn with an example of the if situation.
If you drop an apple, and I'll say that again, if you drop an apple.
And the result?
It falls to the ground.
Once more.
It falls to the ground.
And this result happens every time the situation happens. Isn't that right, Catherine?
That's correct, Neil. It is a scientific fact and it was first identified by Isaac Newton, I believe.
I think you're right. So that's the zero conditional. Let's compare it with an example of the first conditional. Finn.
If you drop that glass, it'll break.
And once again?
If you drop that glass, it'll break.
Now, in this sentence, the if plus present simple part gives us a possible future situation. The other part is made with will plus an infinitive without to, and it gives us the result of this possible future situation.
If you drop that glass, if you drop that glass.
And this is only a possible situation.
It'll break. It'll break.
And this is the result of the situation. We use will to show that we're certain that the glass will break, but it only breaks if we drop the glass.
When we are less certain of the result, we can use might, like this.
If you drop the glass, it might break.
And once again?
If you drop the glass, it might break.
It's sometimes difficult to choose between the zero and first conditional. It helps to remember that as well as using the zero conditional for truths, we also use it for general situations. If you're talking about a specific situation or a one-off situation, the first conditional is probably best. For example, to describe a general situation that is true for everyone, we can use the zero conditional to say,
If you sit in the sun too long, you get burned.
But if your friend's about to go sunbathing, perhaps without any sun cream, you can use the first conditional to talk about that specific situation and its possible result, like this.
If you sit in the sun too long, you will get burned.
6 Minute Grammar from BBC Learning English.
And it's quiz time. Are these sentences grammatically correct or wrong? Here's the first one. When we're older, we'll go travelling.
Okay, this first conditional sentence is correct.
Good. Here's another one. If plants don't get water, they die.
This sentence is correct too.
Mm-hmm. And get ready for the last sentence. If I fail my exams again, I feel terrible.
And that's wrong. It's a specific situation and it's describing a possibility, not a certainty. So we need the first conditional. Here's the correct sentence.
If I fail my exams again, I will feel terrible.
Now, before we go, there's just enough time for a top tip. The first conditional only has one will. So this sentence is wrong.
If they will leave now, they'll be home for lunch.
You need to use present simple without will in the if part. Here's the correct version.
If they leave now, they'll be home for lunch.
Thank you, Finn. So that's a zero conditional with the present tense in both parts for things which always happen.
And that's the first conditional with if plus present simple together with will plus an infinitive for possible future situations.
There's more about this on our website at bbclearningenglish.com. Join us again for more 6 Minute Grammar. Bye.
Bye.
Dear students, I hope you have recognized the use of zero and first conditionals through that video. Now please let's start dealing with that exercise. Sentence 1. If you burn wood, it releases carbon dioxide. Okay, this is a fact, so we should use zero conditional. If is followed by a present simple conditional, and the result is a present simple verb. Sentence 2. If you boil milk, it goes off. Again, this is a zero conditional sentence because it talks about a fact. But the condition in this case is in the negative form, so we say don't boil. Number 3. When drought occurs, people suffer from lack of food. As you can see, dear students, we are using when instead of if. Again, this is a fact. When drought occurs, people suffer. This is a good answer. Thank you very much for your participation. Number 4. People get ill unless they eat healthy food. Very good. Again, this sentence includes unless, which is the negative form of if. And again, this is a fact, so we use the zero conditional. Number 5. When you travel north, temperatures fall sharply. Yes, fall again, because this is a fact. Number 6. The earth gets more polluted as long as factories put off more chlorofluorocarbons, this is CFX, into the atmosphere. Once again, this is a fact which requires a zero conditional. So the earth gets more polluted as long as, in this case, is used instead of if. Thank you very much for your work. Now let's shed more light on the alternative words which we can use instead of saying if, by watching the following video. Then we can continue our tasks.
Hi guys, Dan from BBC Learning English here. In this lesson, we're going to look at 5 ways of saying if without saying if. If you're ready to begin, let's get going. 90 seconds on the clock, here we go. Now, I'm reminded of a conversation that I had with a friend of mine. He said to me, if we go on holiday, shall we go to Europe? I said, as long as we go somewhere hot, I don't mind. As long as is our first way of saying if. It means if and only if. He said, somewhere hot. Suppose we go to America. Would you like that? Suppose is our second way of saying if. Unlike the other forms that we're going to talk about today, suppose is usually used in two sentences. Suppose we go to America, and then followed by a question. Would you like that? Got it? Good. I said to him, listen, unless I get a tan, I'll be really unhappy. Unless is our third way of saying if. It means if not, or except if. And for more information about it, you can find out in our previous lesson. He said to me, well, providing you sunbathe a lot, you'll definitely get a tan. Providing is our fourth way of saying if. It also means if. A more formal version of providing is provided. So I said to him, okay, on the condition that I get time off from work, we'll go to America. On the condition that is our fifth and final way of saying if. It's extremely formal and mostly used in written forms, so perfect for business letters. Whoa! I just made it, can you believe it? Now guys, for more information about this, please go to bbclearningenglish.com. I've been Dan, you've been fantastic, and I'm out of here. Hope to see you soon. Bye.
Hello again, dear students. Now it's time to conclude, to summarize, to work out the rules which are used for zero conditionals and first conditionals. This is exercise B. Look at the examples above and complete the rules. Conditional sentences type 0 are used to talk about a general truth or fact or something that always happens. So, when or if is used plus, yes, that's right, present simple. Then the result clause is very good, present simple. So this is the rule which we use, which applies to zero conditionals. Next, conditional sentences type 1 are used to talk about something which is likely to happen in the present or future. If is followed by very good, present simple. The condition verb should be present simple. And the result clause can contain will, can, must, may, might, should, plus base form or infinitive. It also can be an imperative. Now, gentlemen, let's shed some lights on the alternative words which we can use instead of if. This is exercise C. Read the examples below and answer the questions that follow. Unless you hurry, you will miss your flight. You can borrow my camping equipment as long as provided, providing, on condition that you promise to handle it with care. Last example, supposing trains to London are fully booked, how will we get there? Now it's time to answer questions. Which expression or expressions in blue mean? Number one, only if. Which expressions mean only if? Very good answer. The expressions as long as, provided, providing, on condition that are the same as if. Question two, imagine that. That's nice. Suppose, supposing. Number three, if not. Which word means if not? That's a very good answer. Unless means if not. Thank you very much. Now, let's deal with the following exercise, please. Hello again, dear students, and welcome to our final exercise for today. Rewrite the sentences using the words given. Sentence 1. You must book the tickets at least a week in advance. Otherwise, you won't find any. Of course, you won't find any tickets. You are asked to use the word unless. Amazing answer. Unless you book the tickets at least a week in advance, you won't find any. Of course, this is first conditional. The condition verb is book. The result clause is won't find, will not find. Sentence 2, we'll get a discount on the cruise if we pay in cash. We are asked to use the word provided. Good answer. We'll get a discount on the cruise provided we pay in cash. Provided here means if. Sentence 3, take some days off and we'll go to the Canary Islands on holiday. If. This is a good suggestion. Very good. If you take some days off, we will go to the Canary Islands on holiday. Our final sentence is, I'll stay in a hostel, but it must be close to the major sites as long as. Amazing. This is a correct answer. I'll stay in a hostel as long as it is close to the major sites. Dear students, I'm really grateful to you for your enthusiastic participation, and I hope that you have benefited from today's lesson. Thank you very much and goodbye.
مجمع الأندلس التعليمي تعلم عصري ملهم بهوية وطنية وقيم إسلامية.